Morning, Katie Munn here with Monday Musings. It's a beautiful Monday here in Portland, Maine. And today on Monday Musings, we are going to be talking about boundaries and boundary setting. So boundaries are one of the most important things we can do in our life, setting healthy boundaries, because it not only tells ourselves what is acceptable and what's not acceptable, it also tells the universe what we're willing to accept in our life and what we're not willing to accept in our life. So boundaries to me, in essence, is telling your truth and telling your truth and not being afraid of how others are going to receive it or how others are going to respond. Boundary setting, like I said, is so important, but sometimes it can be so hard because you're dealing with other people's emotions. You want to please other people. You don't want to hurt anyone else's feelings. And so sometimes it can be really tricky to navigate to set a proper boundary. Recently, I had an experience with a friend that every time we interacted, I just felt like the interaction was uneven. You know, I was showing up energized and excited, and they were kind of just in a different spot. And it just became a pattern over and over. It didn't feel good, but I didn't want to tell the person because I knew that they were going through a hard time in their life. And I didn't sort of want to rock the boat, if you were to say, but I also, in the dynamic, felt like it was kind of one way and I wasn't getting my needs met. So after some reflection, I decided to let the person know. And the response was really lovely. I was really afraid of the response. I was afraid the person was gonna be mad or upset or angry. But the person said, you know, I hear you and I understand where you're coming from. And I respectfully acknowledge your feelings and I apologize. And there wasn't necessarily any sort of dialogue that things were going to shift or things were going to change. But the individual, you know, they said they heard me and they respected how I was feeling. And so honestly, it was the best outcome that I could have asked for because, you know, my needs were heard. They were acknowledged. They weren't necessarily met, but it really felt good and powerful. And they actually said to me, thank you for speaking your truth. Right? And so something was sitting deep down inside of me that just didn't feel right. And I was sitting on that for a while. And finally, like, you know, I was like, you know, I need to speak my truth. I need to tell this person how I'm feeling. And I'm afraid how it's going to turn out. But I can no longer be in this uncomfortable spot, right? So that was a way of a boundary coming out very well. And sometimes boundaries, you know, you may tell a person like, hey, this is what I need, or this isn't working for me. And they may get kind of upset and they may not be as responsive as you wish they would be. But having said that, as long as you're being true to yourself and being true to your needs, then that's all that really counts. Because if you're doing something that sits uneasy with you over and over and over again, how's that going to manifest in your life? It's going to manifest in probably some anxiety. It's going to manifest in maybe sleeplessness or feeling on edge or getting easily frustrated or easily emotional. So, right, when we don't speak our truths, when we don't set proper boundaries, when people may be taking advantage of us or pushing the limits or the boundaries over and over and over again, that energetically, if we're not in alignment of what's going on, it's going to wreak havoc in our body. Our body is going to tell us like, hey, look, something's up. Something isn't working, right? So in order to set proper boundaries, you know, what I talk about a lot, cultivating mindfulness, awareness, curiosity, noticing when you're in a situation and it just doesn't feel quite right, you know, what's going on with the situation and why doesn't it quite feel right, and sort of reflecting on that. Because sometimes things, we get triggered, right? And so sometimes things can stir the pot that actually don't even have to do with the situation, has to do with us and our unhealed areas in our life. But when you sort of reflect on a situation, you're like, yeah, this still doesn't feel good. Then setting a boundary is a great thing you can do for yourself. And, you know, it may not happen the first time or the second time or the third time. And sometimes you need to repeat something over and over and over again, right? And that often happens. Like the universe sends us, you know, different people, different scenarios, but in essence, the same thing is going on over and over and over again until we learn our lesson. And usually learning our lesson means setting a proper boundary and being like, nope, this doesn't work for me anymore. I'm moving over here. So once you've acknowledged in your life something isn't working, speaking up, speaking your truth, telling the other individual, like, hey, this isn't working, and just being ready for whatever the response may be. You may be greeted with love, you may be greeted with somebody being like, okay, how do we fix this? Or you may be greeted like I was, acknowledging, yeah, this is what's going on, but maybe necessarily not getting what you really want out of the situation. You may be met with anger or frustration, right? But that often has to do with the other person and what's going on with them. But speaking your truth, speaking your mind, is one of the most beautiful things you can do for yourself, because you're honoring yourself, you're honoring your essence, you're honoring your emotions, and then you can go through your day and be like, you know what, I spoke my truth and I set that boundary. So if you are having trouble with boundary setting, a lovely flower essence that I would love to recommend is yarrow. And yarrow is in full bloom right now. And yarrow is specifically for those boundaries. So if you are empathetic like I am, and you sort of absorb other people's energy and sometimes take on their energy, yarrow flower essence is beautiful. Or if you're needing to set a firm, strong boundary in your life with a loved one or with a workplace member or whatnot, taking the yarrow flower essence can sort of help you stand tall in your truth and really set those proper boundaries that you need. And also, if you're in a healing healthcare profession, such as a doctor, a nurse, a psychologist, anything to that effect, or just working with people, yarrow is really lovely too for, like I said, that energetical boundary exchange. So, you know, you're keeping your firm boundary, you're hearing their story, you're empathetic, you're compassionate, you're kind, but you're not taking on their energy. So, everyone, I hope today you, if you have any area of your life that feels a little bit uneasy and you're needing to set a boundary, that you can do that standing tall and firm in your truth and who you know you are. I love you all so, so, so much, and I will see you next week. Okay, bye.